Meet Ben. He looks like a pretty normal 8-year-old, except for one fact. Ben is actually a child prodigy. He's been playing the piano since he was just 5 years old. One day, Ben's mother was playing the piano, when little Ben walks over and starts plunking out the same keys his mother was, starting with one key at a time, until finally he had both of his hands going. His parents realized that he had a special gift. Ben was homeschooled by his mother so he would have more time to practice his piano. He would do his schoolwork and go right to practicing. He didn't really have many friends, or any really. He would just sit in his room and play Vivaldi, Beethoven, and even Mozart. Eventually, people heard of his talent and wanted to hear him play. After just a year, he had the opportunity to play at the Salzburg Festival along with many other famous musicians. After the festival, Ben felt so special. He loved the attention he received from everyone. His parents also saw how good he was getting, and they didn't want him to quit playing. They pushed him to practice every day. Eventually, Ben started to get a little tired of the constant playing. He wanted to be able to go outside and play. His parents knew that if they wanted him to succeed, he would have to get a higher level of education than his mother could give to him. So they sent him to school for the first time. Ben wasn't entirely sure how to act in a school setting, so he tried to be just like everyone else. When they laughed, he laughed. When they were quiet, he was even quieter. And when they went outside for recess, Ben stood outside the door frozen. He had never played sports with other kids before. The boys were all playing soccer on the field and surprisingly called Ben over to join them. Ben ran over with a big grin on his face and was ready to play. That was, until it was his turn to kick the ball. He ran up to it and gave it a big swing, but missed the ball completely and fell backward to the ground. As all the boys laughed and looked at Ben, Ben got up, dusted himself off, and tried his best to fight back his tears. When he got home, he couldn't get the thought of those boys laughing at him out of his head. His mom asked him how his first day of school was, and Ben replied with a despairing, "Fine," as he walked past his mom to the piano. The next day at school, Ben did all he could not to be noticed by the other boys. He stayed to himself at his desk and didn't want to move when it was time for recess. All the kids walked right past him like he wasn't even there. Even though Ben didn't want to be noticed by anyone, he just really wanted a friend. The next few days weren't any different, and Ben wasn't sure about school anymore. He longed for someone to come over and talk to him, or invite him over to their house after school, but he realized he was all alone. Ben was struggling with intimacy versus isolation, which Erik Erikson describes as a psychosocial state of development that occurs when someone looks for a meaningful relationship with someone, but doesn't find what they're looking for. Because Ben was alone, he gave up on the kids at school, and went back to focusing on his piano playing. As Ben got older, he continued to practice, and he continued to play in front of a large crowd. But the crowd seemed to be getting smaller. It wasn't just the crowds that were decreasing, but also Ben's love for playing the piano. He didn't want to play it anymore. It was only because his parents wanted him to. His career started to take off when restaurants and theaters were calling Ben's mother to leave or to have him come play for them. But now Ben takes his posters around to local bars and restaurants, but nobody knows who he is. They no longer know him as the child prodigy he used to be. Growing up, Ben was so used to the attention he always received, feeling famous and being everyone's favorite little piano player. That no longer is his reality, and he struggles with getting used to know his new reality. Ben is now 22 years old and nobody knows his name. He goes to a psychotherapist thinking he will finally figure out what he can do to gain back his childhood fame. Instead, he learns how to deal with not being the center of attention anymore. After a few sessions together, Ben decides he's going back to school and get a college degree. He found a college that suited him, and he went to study computer engineering, something he became very attached to as he spent so many hours alone in his room. He continued to see his therapist once a week, and after 3 long weeks, Ben went to their next meeting with a big problem. He was back into his middle school days, feeling alone and unaccepted. Ben never learned how to act around a crowd. He could never find the words to say to keep a conversation going. His therapist helped him learn what things were appropriate to say and how to approach someone and start a conversation. At first it was hard, as he would often find himself staring at the other person with his mouth hanging open and nothing coming out. But after a few weeks of trial and error, Ben started to get more comfortable around others. Soon he had many friends on campus, and he felt very comfortable talking to them, as well as his professors. Ben graduated after 4 years and got a job. Along his time in school, he met a girl named Lydia, and they started dating. After 2 years together, Ben felt the love he always longed for. He went back to his therapist to tell her the good news. After talking it over with her, he decided he was going to ask Lydia to marry him. She said yes, and they got married. Now we fast forward 4 years to see Ben with a steady job, a wife, and 2 kids. He even went back to his piano playing he hadn't played in about 9 years. Now he occasionally goes back to his piano to play the songs he played as a child. There was a new purpose behind his piano playing, though. It's no longer for his parents or even for a large crowd, but instead, it's for his own enjoyment and happiness, and it's played for an audience of 3.